Okay, and we are going to say hello and good morning to Anthony Grant, who joins us today to discuss the news you missed while scanning the headlines. What did I miss, Tony?
Well, good morning, first of all.
Amen.
Nice to see you.
On this very, very, very hectic morning.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, leading right into it, Haaretz has a story about Iran, the U.S. to offer Iran sanctions relief in return for steps to stop nuclear program. So, this is not a huge shocker. What's going on beyond the eve of yet more nuclear talks? This is coming from a U.S. official, unnamed as in this article, and that's of course huge
news.
These
talks are beginning today.
Right.
You know, we've conflicting reports is everything and anything that has to do with the Middle East. You know, Iranians optimistic, then they're not. The world not optimistic, and yet.
And that's a headline that is probably not going to go down very well in sort of Netanyahu's office, they're saying it's not the moment to start talking about sanctions relief. But from the White House, we're getting those signals that
they're going to do what they want.
Might be in the offing.
What else?
The Guardian, of course, is reporting on the Yasser Arafat may have been poisoned with polonium tests show. Of course, we just looked into this. It's kind of a moderate headline. It's you know, and actually moderate is the operative.
May have.
The report, of course, moderately supports the proposition that the death was the consequence of poisoning. So they're treading a very low-key line, I would say.
Very much so. And you know, to me, it was fascinating to see this actually break last night on several news agencies because the timing of it is just so wrong.
Right. And speaking of crazy timing, the Washington Post, I want to talk about this story that they ran the other day, but it's still prominently featured online. Greater Israel, faction says no to two-state solution, yes to annexing Palestinian areas. Now, this article is about the very vocal faction in Netanyahu's government, which is quite opposed to the idea of a Palestinian state, specifically Danny Danon, who is the deputy defense minister, who says that he thinks more in terms of Palestinian settlements in Israel than in terms of Jewish settlements in the West Bank. Now, this is not a big surprise, this faction is vocal. I mean, we know about this. This is not a secret. Interesting, though, that why would the Washington Post run this story right now at this sensitive time with Kerry back? Are they trying to throw a little bit of cold water on things?
I don't know if it's throwing cold water, but I think it's actually a way. You know, I will counter. I will counter you on that because this is the sticking point. I think very, very, very few times we hear that the settlements are an issue that will have to be put on the table, and also in the social discourse, in the international arena. And in that respect, it's a way to explain it to people in the international arena. At the end of the day, the Palestinians want a land that is called Palestine. Most of it will be in the West Bank. Right now, Jewish settlements are sprinkled all over it. And that's why it's called an occupation. So in that, I mean, I think that the Washington Post is trying to bring back into the table something that is, you know, isn't being talked about in, you know, in the last few years, but is the crust of these negotiations.
Yeah, well, it's definitely something that's going to raise eyebrows on both sides of the Atlantic.
What else?
Speaking of the Atlantic, the Daily Express, United Kingdom, reports that Rebecca Brooks of News Corporation, or formerly of, knew about hacking of Millie Dowler's phone. This is the big British phone hacking scandal with tabloids. And Millie Dowler is the British schoolgirl who had gone missing and was later found murdered.
Yeah, this is
and
what broke this whole thing up.
This is still at the crux of this. And apparently the Old Bailey, the court in Britain, has been told that that Rebecca Brooks, the former executive, made a phone call while she was on vacation in Dubai to talk about Millie Dowler, which would indicate that she knew
potentially about the
phone call was hacked. So the drama continues there in London with this scandal.
You know, the fascinating world of journalism.
Yeah.
Little did we know. And sadly, we have time for just one more.
The Independent in the UK reports on Toronto's Mayor Rob Ford, who has admitted to smoking from a crack pipe during what he calls a drunken stupor.
Well, that makes it okay.
But he maintains he's not an addict and he's not stepping down. So, yeah.
Canada has never been so exciting.
Yeah, and the Canadians are starting to get a little bit uneasy with this guy because they've got a squeaky clean image
until now.
Yeah, but they're not, they're very cool about it, but they think, some people think he needs to work out his problems. Some people think that, you know, he needs to step down, but it's not really like throw the rat out. It's
okay,
sort of,
still,
they're watching
you know,
and waiting.
I'm gonna invoke the late Whitney Houston say that crack is whack.
Yeah.
there I have it.
Oh, Canada.
For the Canadians, oh, Canada. Tony, darling, thank you so much.
Thank you.
You will join me in the next hour. but we're going to make you laugh. Yes.
Well, starting with Twitter, actually, Twitter, of course, has gone IPO.
Oh, okay.
It will be.
That's not a laughing matter.
It's not a laughing matter. Actually, exciting because a roller coaster ride is in store for Wall Street because it's going to be offered at $26 a share to start.
But, 26?
But the sources
that's
on
huge.
The street, yeah, but by the end of the day in New York, they're saying it'll be up to $50. That's what people are. The buzz.
Is that there? I mean, that's insane buzz. In
that's
that
yeah.
I mean,
but
that makes me think that Twitter is running the world.
It is.
Yeah, it is.
We're
in
just
many
pawns
ways.
Of Twitter.
140 characters. The Iranians will attest to that. The Twitter is running
no
the world.
No doubt. Yeah. Zarif is
very
major.
Master.
Yes.
But you know, just to stay on this for a little while, this did not go so well for Facebook last, you know, as the last social
right.
media service.
Yeah,
right?
I mean, Facebook is so 5 minutes ago. It's all about Twitter, right?
It's all about Twitter.
Yeah,
fine.
Come on.
So Facebook's so 2012.
So all eyes on New York today to see how high that price is going to go.
Yeah, okay.
And in Sweden, all eyes are on the movies. The Atlantic Wire reports that feminism.
I'm like, there's news from Sweden.
Okay. Yeah, Sweden. We love Sweden. Movies are going to get a feminist rating in Sweden, but most will still fail. This is. There's a new system. There's going to be rating movies based on gender bias in Sweden, and to get an A rating, a movie needs to have two named female characters who talk to each other about something other than guys.
We actually do that. You know what? We actually manage to do that, we females, as you've just noticed.
Yeah. I mean, hey, Holiday in Stockholm? Let's go.
No. Okay, so Sweden.
Interesting to see. A very progressive country, but let's see. Most movies are going to flunk that test, I think. They're saying Lord of the Rings, Star Wars would all have.
In Lord of the Rings, chicks talk about guys?
I only saw half of it. I don't know. But
did you see that elf go by? Whatever.
Gandalf.
What else?
Or did you see those rats?
Yeah.
The Daily Star, United Kingdom, reports on the rat invasion in England. Now, the Brits, not surprisingly, sourced the rats to France. Now, apparently,
of course, not surprising.
Not surprising. Yeah. Now, apparently, these are toxin resistant rats.
But they're not just big rats. They're killer mutant rats.
Yeah, okay. They are resistant to all
that
sorts.
That thing looks terribly cute to me, but yeah.
I don't know. I mean, it's
Who have they been attacking?
British people. Yeah, I don't know. They've made their way up to Scotland. Apparently, now they're on the loose. And people are calling for stronger poison.
Stronger poison to kill
them.
And
they're mutant.
They're mutant rats. Wow. Mutant rats from France.
Yeah.
Little tit for tat there.
I'm just thinking this is an attempt to start another
100 years war between England and France.
England and France. And it's all because of the mutant France. Yeah, it's the mutant rats.
The mutant rats from maybe they speak French. I don't know.
Yeah.
But anyways, also actually the Daily Star, which is a great British tabloid, talks about Jennifer Aniston and her new image. She recently worked the stripper pole in sexy suspenders for her film We're the Millers. And I was not aware of this movie, actually, but it was out in August, I think, in the U.S. It's a different kind of Jennifer than we're used to.
It's a very different kind of Jennifer Aniston, and I'm hating my body right now.
I mean, come on. But she doesn't look very happy in these behind-the-scenes pictures from this set. I don't know. She's sort of like, am I really doing this? That's the kind of look that she...
Yeah. Why am I... I don't know. I'm still hating her body. Well, my body. Yeah, there we have it.
I don't know. It's,
She's in her mid-40s. It's
she's 44.
She's 44, right?
Yeah. 44, but going on 18.
Yeah.
Judging by those pictures, so.
Yeah.
Also, in weird news, I would say, there's reports circulating on the internet, and I found one on this website called gayrussia.eu, that one Russian
town. That site
town,
is still up?
Yeah.
Okay.
Apparently, a Russian region, which I dare not pronounce, Arkhangelsk, whatever, has canceled the first law banning the so-called gay propaganda. Now, this is...
And now they're all in jail?
No. This is, thankfully, but apparently there's the regional one of the regional versions of this law, because the federal law in Russia also has local iterations.
Right.
They canceled it out, and this is actually documented now. This happened a couple of days ago. Not sure why, and the reports are kind of murky.
No, but fascinating that actually this is being done within internally in the legal system, and
yeah.
It gives one hope.
Yeah.
You know, in many ways. And finally,
also Russian tractor videos are burning up the internet. Modern Farmer, my favorite crop site.
It's jaw-dropping Russian tractor videos.
Yeah, apparently watching tractors run amok is a hobby in Russia. And
why does that not surprise me? I didn't see them going for the cat video.
How about Putin shirtless on a tractor?
Yeah,
you know? I mean, that could be. Yeah, it's a way of bringing people back to the land, getting in touch with agriculture. Macho country.
Спасибо. Tractors. On that note, Tony, thank you. After the break, guys, Twitter, as we said.
Thank you.